brothers and sisters. Of course, our briefing will be as follows. We have the official statement from the panelists. Then you'll have the open forum for your airtime, and we will have some announcements after that. Let us now start with an introduction from the chairman of the Committee on Information and Media Relations, Bishop Mylo Vergara.
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. No? Welcome to our series of press briefings. If you recall, we already had two. The first briefing was sort of a general introduction to the schedule of the papal visit from January 15 to 19, 2015. And then the second was about the arrival and departing ceremonies of the Holy Father. And this concerns basically what will happen in Villamor Air Base. We are now on the third press briefing, and the particular aspect we want to focus and inform the public is about the event in the Manila Cathedral, which was actually part of the prayer of Monsignor Nestor Cerbo. We are blessed, no, because we were able to invite Cardinal Luis Antonio Tagle, who is fresh from Rome. And amoy Rome pa po siya. And we know that he has been actually still being asked to go there because of the aftermath of the special synod, no, on the family. And he may be able to give us some updates also as far as Rome is concerned with regards to the preparations for the upcoming papal visit. We're also fortunate that Monsignor Nestor Cerbo, the Rector of Manila Cathedral, is here, no, to give us some updates on some preparations, no, in the Manila Cathedral event. And for the government side, Undersecretary Jess Yu, no, to also brief us, no, on how the government will help us with regards to the proper movements and protocol given this visit of Pope Francis for our Basilica here in Manila.
Thank you, Bishop Mylo Vergara. As was mentioned, we will have a major event in Manila Cathedral of Pope Francis for the priest and religious. So without much ado, fresh from Rome, the Archbishop of Manila and the Chairman of the Committee for the Papal Visit 2015, His Eminence Cardinal Chito Tagle.
Gandang hapon po sa inyo lahat. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Buonasera. Buonasera a tutti. As already indicated by Bishop Mylo and the opening prayer of Monsignor Cerbo, now we shall tackle this afternoon the first Mass of the Holy Father, Pope Francis, during his pastoral visit. And it will happen in the Manila Cathedral on the 16th of January. Alam po ninyo, para sa simbahang Kristiyano, lalo na sa simbahang Katolika, ang Santa Misa, ang Eucharistia, ang pinaka mataas na uri ng pagsamba sa Diyos. It is a high point. In fact, we can say it is the highest point of worship. For Christ is present in His Word, in His body and blood, in the community, convoked by the Holy Spirit, and also in the ministers. And in the three full days that the Holy Father will be with us, every day He will have a public Eucharistic celebration. On the 16th of January, it will be held in the Manila Cathedral, the minor basilica of the Immaculate Conception. And mamaya siguro si Monsignor Cerbo ay makakapagpaliwanag kung ano ang significance ng Manila Cathedral, no po, para sa kasaysayan ng Pilipinas at ng Kristyanismo sa Pilipinas. The Mass to be held in the Manila Cathedral will be attended by bishops, priests, and religious. This first Mass that will be open primarily to bishops, priests, and religious is meant to highlight the pastoral character of the visit of the Pope. His first encounter liturgically is with the leaders of the church and those who are called to consecrated life. It will be a regular Mass. Kaya po kung tayo ay sanay na nagsisimba, wala po tayo makikitang parang kakaiba naman. No, it is a regular Mass of the day. The prayers will be taken from the Mass for the church, prayers for the church. Ang medyo lang po na masasabi nating mga ilang features ay to reflect not only the Filipino culture but also the universal culture, the Mass will be multilingual. Kasi tayo naman sa Pilipinas ay multilingual. Tapos po, dahil ito ay pagbisita ng head of the Universal Catholic Church, kaya maganda rin na sa pamamagitan, sa loob ng misa, ay maramdaman natin yung internationality of the Church. The other important feature is, instead of the regular penitential rite, naho yung Lord of Mercy, yung I confess to Almighty God at the beginning of the Mass, we will have what we call the confession of sins. Confessio peccati. Naho, confession of sin. At ito po ay magaganap sa pamamagitan ng maliit na ritual. Ang mga obispo, pari, at mga religious ay hihingi ng tawad sa Diyos sa pagkukulang at mga kasalanan, hindi lamang bilang tao at bilang mga Kristiyano, kundi bilang mga pinuno ng simbahan. Na po. At yung tatlong paghingi ng tawad ay nakaugnay sa mga pangako sa obedience, poverty, and chastity. Na po. At sa bawat panalangin ng paghingi ng tawad, dalawang pari o religious ang lalapit sa harapan ng krusipiho ni Jesus. Yung isa ay maghahayag ng paghingi ng tawad, at yung isa naman maglalagay ng insenso sa isang lalagyan para yung panalangin ay masabayan ng pag-aakyat sa langit ng usok na nagmumula sa insenso. No po. So yun po ang isang mahalagang feature. And finally, the whole Mass will also focus on the theme of the papal visit, mercy and compassion, in two ways. The priests, the religious, the bishops are reminded that we also need to experience God's mercy and compassion. For just like the rest of humanity, we are weak, we are sinners, we are always in the hands of the merciful God. And we can be sustained in our ministry only if we drink from the wells of God's mercy and compassion. So, yung mga pari, mga madre, mga religious, mga obispo, ang unang magsasabi, kailangan naming maranasan din ang habag at malasakit ng Panginoon. And secondly, we will be reminded, hopefully by the liturgy and by the Holy Father, that one of the essential or the most important tasks or ministries of the ordained and also the witness of the religious is for us to be agents of mercy and compassion. We receive mercy and compassion from God. we are also instruments and ministers of mercy and compassion. Kaya po yung reading, yung first reading is from St. Paul, telling us, you are ministers of reconciliation. At yung gospel po ay yung pakikipagkita ni Kristo muling nabuhay kay Pedro. Alam naman natin si Pedro nagkasala. Itinatwa niya si Jesus 3 beses. Pero yun sa gospel, yun yung 3 beses tinanong ni Jesus si Pedro, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Now, the offer of mercy, and then the Lord entrusts His flock, His sheep, to Peter. So, yan po ang some of the salient points of the Eucharistic celebration that will be held in the Manila Cathedral on January 16, 2015. So, salamat po.
Thank you, His Eminence, for that exhaustive explanation of this beautiful Mass of the Holy Father, the first Mass ng ating Santo Papa sa Pilipinas, no? Sa mga pari at mga obispo at mga religyoso sa Manila Cathedral. Kaya yung diwa ng mercy and compassion, you cannot give but you don't receive, no? Kailang madama muna ng mga pari at obispo kami. Madama namin ang awa at pagmamalasakit ng Diyos sa pamamagitan ng aming pagbabalik loob. It's a very beautiful and renewing, powerful experience of conversion. No? Let's try to spread that in our media community. The pastoral nature of this Manila Cathedral event with the priest and religious of Pope Francis. To give further sharing of what will happen to the Manila Cathedral event, we have also with us the rector of Manila Cathedral and person in charge of the venue. Let us listen to him, Monsignor Nestor Cerbo.
Thank you. As mentioned by Cardinal, His Eminence Cardinal, I will tell you about the significance of the Manila Cathedral. No, so the Manila Cathedral is the premier church, the premier cathedral, and the premier basilica of the Philippines. Why premier church? Because formerly we were part of the diocese of Mexico, but it came to a point that we will be separated from the diocese of Mexico and that the Philippines will be a separate diocese. So if it will be a separate diocese, we need a cathedral because we have a bishop. No? So they scouted for the church that is worthy to become the cathedral. And that is what you see now, the Manila Cathedral was chosen. So it must have been the premier church during that time. So the second, it is a premier cathedral because by the obvious reason that it is the first cathedral of the Philippines. And lastly, premier basilica, because although it is not the first basilica of the Philippines, but it became a basilica in a very special way. A rare gift of the Holy Father in the person of John Paul II when he came to the Philippines in 1981. So after the Mass, he told Cardinal Sen, who was the Archbishop during the time, he said, I will make this as a basilica. So it is coming from him. Other basilicas became basilica because they petitioned for it. Kami hindi namin, we did not petition for it. It was just given on silver platter. No? So, but we did not realize that actually that was his expression of his greatest love for the Filipinos, giving us this rare gift. Because usually the title of a basilica is rarely given motu proprio. You see? So this is the only basilica in the Philippines which became a basilica motu proprio because the Holy Father himself, on his initiative, say, I will make this as a basilica. Kaya wala, we did not have a hard time, no? Because of so many documentations that you should do. We were just given the documents. So, but that is, we have to look beyond that, that that was the very special love of John Paul, Saint John Paul II for the Filipino people. So, because it is the premier church, the premier basilica, the premier cathedral, and the premier basilica of the Philippines, it is the mother of all churches, cathedrals, and basilicas of the Philippines. So that's only fitting that we would not wonder why the Pope is always, every time he visits to the Philippines, they really have a mass in the, at the Manila Cathedral. When John Paul II, John Paul VI, it was the
Paul VI,
visited the Philippines. He was the first Pope, a pilgrim Pope, no. And we are so lucky that in his the first time the Pope going out of Rome, we were part, no. The Philippines was one of the countries he visited, and he also said Mass at the Manila Cathedral. When John Paul II came here, he also said Mass, and that's why when Pope Francis will come, he will also say Mass at the Manila Cathedral. So, as regards the, I was just asked to tell you about the preparation, the physical preparations that we are doing at the Manila Cathedral. No, actually, we are not undertaking the restoration work because of the visit of the Pope Francis. As you know, we already started the restoration 2 years ago. But we are just happy, no, that God blessed our the restoration work that we are doing with the visit. You know, makin mo. We did not realize that it will happen, no. But our restoration work was blessed, no, by God through the visit of Pope Francis. So that's why we are trying our best, really, to with a limited time, because we did not project that we will finish the restoration. It's a long process, but we are trying to finish what we could finish when he comes. No, so right now we are struggling with how to finish with the air conditioning, because we have upgraded it as a part of our restoration, because it was found out that it is underrated, no. Sa palagi ko naman nakasimba na kayo sa cathedral, we have the aircon, but it is not so cold, no. So we have to upgrade, or we ask a designer to really do the design so that it will be cool enough when people will be there, especially if there are a lot of people, no. Because we are, the capacity of the cathedral is 2,000. And we have to just to limit, for the Pope's visit, we have just to limit to 2,000. Because otherwise, if it is more than that, we might have a problem, no? We have to consider safe, what do you call these safety considerations. We should leave some aisles open in case there will be emergencies. Okay, so 2,000 lang ho. Pero these are for bishops only, for priests and
religious. Thank you, Monsignor. Okay, no. So I hope that you got the message of Monsignor. No, restoration is still ongoing. In other words, donations are still accepted. Okay. Mahalaga sa Manila Cathedral, palaging binanggit ng Monsignor the word premier. Kaya siya po ang premier rector. Now let us have also another panelist. Puro Cardinal, Obispo at Monsignor nagkasalita. Pero meron tayong hindi ordained eh, no? Ano kaya ang kanilang papel sa Manila Cathedral event ng priests and religious with the Holy Father, Pope Francis? Pakinggan natin, representing the government, the Undersecretary of Legislative, Policy and Legal Affairs from the Presidential Communications Operations Office, no other than Undersecretary Jess Yu.
Hi, thank you, Father Anton, Cardinal Tagle, Bishop Mylo, Monsignor Cerbo, good afternoon, friends. The government is in close coordination with the church regarding the visit of His Holiness Pope Francis in January of 2015. The National Organizing Committee, composed of several national government agencies, have been continuously meeting, coordinating, to know about the preparations for the papal visit. And one of the meetings tackled was about the Mass at the Manila Cathedral. We understand the significance of the Pope's visit to the Philippines. Thus, the government will endeavor to make the visit of the Holy Father a meaningful and solemn one. We will continue again to coordinate with the Church regarding the visit of His Holiness Pope Francis. Thank you.
Thank you, Usec Jess Yu. So at this time, after the official statements of our panelists, we will have the second part of our program, our briefing, which is the open forum, to give time, airtime for our media community to further deepen our activities for the papal visit, particularly the Manila Cathedral event, the Mass of the Holy Father with the priests, bishops, and religious. Now it will be opening the floor. Please, SOP, introduce yourself and your outfit, then go with your question inquiry. Yes, sir.
Sir, si Manny Bugato po sa Reuters. Sir, sabi niyo po hihingi ng tawad yung mga bishop at pare. Meron po ba kayong example kung ano yung hihingi niyo ng tawad? Yung ho bang... kasi maraming kaso ng pare na na-involve sa sex cases. Yung iba may mga anak. So ito po ba kasama sa hihingi niyo ng sorry? Tapos si... masasabi niyo po ba ano ang homily ni Pope Francis? Saan po ang kanyang direksyon, ano sasabihin niya sa mga kaparian natin. Thank you.
Thank you. Yung paghingi ng tawad na mapapaloob doon sa Eucharist is, sasabihin natin, communal at saka symbolic. Kasi pag personal ang paghingi ng tawad sa kumpisal, talagang dinidetalye mo yung kasalanan mo kasi personal. Pero ito dahil communitarian, siguro hindi natin maiiwasan na parang may pagka-comprehensive. Katulad niya ng sabi ko, kasi tatlo yung Lord of Mercy, Christ of Mercy, Lord of Mercy. Yung tatlo na panalangin ng paghingi ng tawad ay focus sa mga pagkukulang sa tatlong mga pangako namin. Obedience, na pagtalima, poverty, na pagiging payak, at chastity. Yun, na yung sa celibacy. Kaya doon siguro kasama na doon, mapapaloob na doon. Ano? Hindi na siguro didetalyehin na ganito, ganyan. Pero, tapos, yung homily ng Santo Papa, hindi ko alam kung ano ang nilalaman. No? So, hintayin natin ang kanyang paghahayag sa araw na mismo na yun.
Okay, next. Okay, the gentleman in blue. Pakibanggit din kung sino gustong sumagot ng inyong tanong.
I want to ask you, Sec,
introduce yourself.
My name is Dario Agnote. I write for Kyodo News, Japan's largest news agency. Has the president declared, has the president decided already on whether or not to declare January 16 or 17 a holiday? Thank you.
Yeah, we understand the local government through the Honorable Mayor Joseph Estrada has already declared a holiday for the city of Manila. Now, on the part of the national government, whether or not to declare it as a national holiday, pinag-aaralan po yung need for that. So we will provide you with the necessary updates as soon as natapos na po yung pinag-aaralan, no, regarding that issue that you raised.
But okay. What is the recommendation of the
We are in coordination also with the church regarding that. So, pinag-usapan na po yan, no, regarding that. Gaya po na banggit ni Ambassador June Painor last time, no, it is being considered po to declare January 15 to 19 as holidays. But as far as we know, the City of Manila, through Mayor Estrada, has already declared those days as holidays for the City of Manila. Thank you.
Sabi nga ni Mayor Erap, inunahan ko na sila. Nag-declare na ako ng 5 days. Talaga, no? Can I see some hands? Sandra, and then next. Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Sir, Sandra po, GMA7. For the 2000 that would be allowed.
Who would you like to answer the question? Sino? Okay. kay Cardinal?
Anybody.
Kahit sino na lang po.
Kahit sino na lang, okay.
For the 2,000 who will be allowed inside the Manila Cathedral, I understand, syempre, priority po yung mga religious, ano, pero paano po yung mga ordinaryong tao who also wanted to join, who want to join the Mass?
So, ang pagkakaalam ko sa ano ay this Mass is for the bishops, the priests, and religious. So, ang bibigyan niya, ng bibigyan ng ticket dito ay yung mga yon, no? Maliban lamang sa mga other lay people who are needed in the liturgical celebration, like the choir, kasi hindi naman yun sila mga pare, mga lay people yon, they are liturgical singers. Those who will serve as usherettes, and the medical people, the PSG. So, pero ang allot, what we allotted for the priest and the bishops and the religious is something like 1,500. The rest will be lay people, as I already mentioned, plus the technical experts like for the sound systems, aircon, etc. In case there will be trouble, they are there to take care immediately. The sounds, especially.
If I may just add to that, no, so that it will help also the public to be informed. It is very clear that the event in the Manila Cathedral is not only for the Archdiocese of Manila, no. It should be specified, no, and we should inform the public that all dioceses will be represented in that Mass. No? In fact, it has been decided by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines that for each diocese, and this includes also prelatures and apostolic vicariates, there will be 10 priests and 5 religious, no, who will attend that Mass. No? So it is upon the decision of, or the process of each diocese, each particular church as we call it, to send their own representatives. No? We have to also make sure that this was given to us beforehand, especially for the steering committee, because we have to come out with IDs for them for security reasons. No? So you see, as was given to us by Monsignor Nestor Cerbo, we can only hold as much as 2,000 in that cathedral. But we also discussed that if there are other priests who may not be the representation and would want to attend the event outside the cathedral, we will try to come up with perhaps physical amenities to accommodate them. If there may be a video wall there or LCD, they can still be part of the whole celebration. No? So I'd also like to point out the significance of this Mass, and I'd like to support Cardinal Tagle's presentation, that we look at the Holy Father as someone, no, who will be a father to his ordained and consecrated servant leaders in the Philippines. Kaya sa totoo lang, we are looking forward to Pope Francis, no, kasi mangangaral siya sa amin, di ba? Kami pong mga obispo, mga pare, mga religious, no, at sasabihin po niya sa amin kung ano dapat ang uri ng paglilingkod namin, no, lalo na dito po sa Pilipinas, no. I also gather, it should also be noted that there will be Asian bishops who will come. So we're just waiting for their confirmation. Some have already confirmed, no, because we know this is also, in terms of the globe, a regional celebration. No? So they will be coming and they will be part, no, of the Manila Cathedral celebration. No? So there will be a number. No, we have allotted some seats for them. And we need to know also who will come for security reasons, no, because they will be given an ID, as Usec, Jess Yu said, no, we're cooperating with the government to also secure the Manila Cathedral for that event.
Okay. Paano pinili, Bishop, yung mga priest? Yung iba nagbunutan or iba-iba, no?
Iba-ibang paraan, eh. No? Kasi I could speak for my own diocese, the Diocese of Pasig, we drew lots. so that it's fair, no? So in fact, it would be difficult because there are, let's say, 10 priests, no, and 5 religious. So if in a diocese there are many religious congregations, what we did, we drew lot per congregation so that it would be fair, so that whoever will be sent by the religious congregation representing Pasig, no, they will be the one to draw lots themselves.
Yung isang pare nga sa Diocese of Pasig, eh, bigla na pasigaw, answered prayers daw siya. Ang aga ng Pasko niya. Okay. Ma'am? Okay, more?
Siguro maano rin yung cut-off time, 10 o'clock in the morning. Nakasabi doon, sa mga pare ito, tsaka, no, there will be tight security also. Okay. There will be a scanner. Kasi kahit mga pare in Madre, they have to walk through the scanners. At saka 10 o'clock yung cut-off. If you are late, whether you are a priest or a bishop,
religious,
yeah, hindi ka na makapasok.
Isasala na po ni Monsignor Cerbo.
No, it's the PSG. The PSG will be very strict, you know, because they are protecting the security of the Pope. So, cut off time, whether you have an ID or ano, basta hindi ka nakapasok ng 10, sa labas na ho kayo.
Okay, take note.
Maidagdag ko rin, no, para malaman nyo. Halimbawa na finalized na po yung list, no, kasi pinasubmit na po sa amin. Let's say on that event, hindi makakapunta yung pare, hindi po ire-replace ng ibang pare for security reasons also. We have already determined that, no, and it was specified also by Archbishop Socrates Villegas that there will be no last-minute replacements in case one will not be able to attend.
Thank you, Bishop, for the clarification. No substitute, no proxy. Yes, ma'am.
Good morning. Simone Orendine for Catholic News Service. Cardinal Tagle, I think you might have touched on this, but is the Pope going to, and I'm seeing the schedule, so I think it might happen on Friday. Is the Pope going to speak with religious leaders, and will they be able to have a dialogue or a meeting in the same way that they did in Korea, where some of the bishops were able to bring the issues of their different dioceses? Are they going to have that kind of meeting on the day of the Mass with the religious?
You mean religious leaders, meaning the same bishops and the priests who will attend the Mass? Yeah, I don't think it is part of the schedule, what you're saying, the separate dialogue. I think the interaction will happen mainly within the Eucharistic celebration.
Then maybe I'm getting ahead of myself on the schedule. Will that happen on the Friday of the visit? Oh, that is the Friday. I'm sorry. At UST, will something like
that? Yeah, in UST, there will be an encounter of the Holy Father with leaders of other religions. Yeah, yes.
Thank you.
Okay, any other question? Yes. Okay. This is the microphone.
I am covering for National Catholic Reporter. I just want to follow up on that. Why, Cardinal, why will there not be one such dialogue? Is it not needed or something? Or time?
You know, honestly, I do not know. Because it was the decision of the Pope to have this schedule.
Schedule?
It was, yes, it was the decision of the Pope.
Okay,
yes.
Thanks.
Glenn Luego po sa DCBB. You suggest, or kahit sino po, nakikita ko po kasi nasa screen, ayun na po ba yung latag nung oras nung pupunta ng Santo Papa?
Yes, yan po ang tentative schedule na pinag-usapan, no? As discussed also with the Church and the Vatican. So kung may mga changes po yung final schedule, then we will notify you. Kung ano. Pero as of today, yan po yung schedule na nakalatag.
Kaya makatulong po yung ating weekly briefing, no, to abreast you of the development. Any other question? Meron pa iba? The rest? The other outfit? Yes, sir. Then Sandra.
Magandang hapon ulit. I was just wondering, can you elaborate a little bit on what the Pope is going to do in Malacanang? Paano niyo pala pinili po yung what we call this, yung mga politicos for instance who want to kiss the hands of the Pope, mga ganun. Nagkaroon din ho ba ng draw lot?
I think yung pong regarding sa Malacanang courtesy call, I think this is covered by another press briefing. So doon na lang po natin i-discuss so, yung regarding yung visit po ng Papa sa Malacanang. Okay. Alin po? Yeah, I think this is covered by a separate ano, base po dun sa binigay po ni Father Anton.
Yeah, okay. It's supposed to be on December 29 as approved by the Bldg committee. December 29 for the Malacanang encounter. Sandra. After microphone.
Follow-up ko lang, pa-clarify ko lang po kasi dahil po may pagka-rockstar din po yung Pope natin. Baka po kung nasan siya, marami ring tao. So kung halimbawa po sa Manila Cathedral, dadatingan yung mga tao doon, papaligiran nila yung Cathedral or magpa-flock sila doon sa harap. So paano mo yun? Iko-control sila o pwede rin mo sila maki-join doon?
Regarding po dyan, Sandra, no, may ginagawin na po ang MMDA, DPWH, in coordination with the PNP, no, regarding doon sa crowd control. Kasi if you will notice, dito po sa area, hindi na po gano'ng kalakihan. So there should be crowd control, no, to ensure the safety, not only of the Pope, at yung mga dadalo po, including ho yung mga kababayan natin. So, magkakaroon po ng crowd control. Again, magbibigay po tayo ng abiso no, regarding that. Pina-finalize na po ngayon ng National Organizing Committee no, regarding that. No. Magbibigay po tayo ng kaukulang abiso no, regarding that.
Pero mahalaga din ang role ng media no, para sabihin natin mga kababayan na sumunod tayo sa kaayusan no, at kapayapaan ng pagdiriwang. Any other?
Sir, follow-up po. Cardinal, ano po? I only discourage yung mga politiko natin, yung mga barangay officials na maglagay pa ng welcome banner. Welcome po. Ganun po.
Wala naman sigurong masama na mag-welcome sa Pope. Basta welcome lang. Na
wala pong muka.
Naka-welcome Pope tapos hindi mukha ni Pope ang nandun. Ah, para medyo iba-iba na yun. Ano?
Any other question from other outfit? Sa likod, yes. Yes. The woman in black.
Okay.
Please introduce yourself.
Reverend Cerbo po. Ira Pedraza po sa ABS-CBNnews.com. Regarding the reconstruction works, yung aircon na lang ba ang problema or meron pa tayong ibang inaayos?
Hello.
Pwede nyo na po sabihin no, pang mga kailangan nyo. Maisulat nyo.
Siguro magbibigay siya ng donasyon. Ano? yung sa everything sa restoration works, other works are going on smoothly. Kaya lang dito sa aircon, kasi some of the parts of the aircon will have to be ordered from other countries like China. Kaya ang nabibinbin ngayon, nadi-delay, what is being delayed is isang air handling units. So, we hope that because we still have time, we are expecting that it will arrive within this week. So help us pray. Kasi pag sinabi nilang Monday, magsaslide ang Tuesday. Tapos magsaslide ng Wednesday. No? So, but we pray and hope that this will be delivered sana within this week na.
Okay, let's pray and hope for the best for the aircon. Yes, sir.
Sir, tatanong ko lang yung media coverage sa loob ng cathedral. Meron bang allowed ba yung media sa loob at ilan yung papasok doon?
Meron pong media area para sa media no, yung mga pupunta po doon. So we will keep you abreast no, given your accreditation no, and as you well know, given all the activities of the Holy Father, there are places that are limited no, unlike if you are in the Luneta Mass, it's a wide space no, but here you know it's the Manila Cathedral, you will fill in bishops, priests, religious, and as Monsignor Nestor told us, no, there are lay people with their particular roles and functions, no, but there is a media area that can sort of hold representations from your end, no? So we will keep you abreast about it, but also consider that it is a limited space.
And you are very privileged because you will be near the Pope.
Ay, hindi. Well, wala pa ho. Meron na ho.
We allotted 150.
So.
Okay, so we have more questions. Saying opportunity, the Cardinal is here. Any questions from the media?
Ako. Ako, may tanong. Pwede ba, pwedeng ako na magtanong sa kanila?
Ay, magtanong, Cardinal.
hindi naman siguro talaga tanong, no? First of all, I would like to thank you in the name of the committee of Bishop Mylo, the CBCP, Archbishop Sok, and the Church in the Philippines. You know, not everyone can come to the individual events, but thanks to you who will cover, this becomes a national event, it becomes a regional event, and truly an international event. So your role is crucial. And as we thank you, we also want to remind you that this is a great opportunity, a blessing, a grace for you to be able to be present and to cover such an event. Kaya po rin, inaanyayahan namin kayo na habang tinatanong nyo ang gobyerno at ang simbahan tungkol sa preparation, kayo rin po ay aming inaanyayahan na maghanda para sa pagdalaw ng Santo Papa. Hindi lang po ng inyong mga kamera, ng inyong mga gadgets, kundi lalo na po yung paghahanda, napasok yung diwa, no, noong ng visit. Kaya ho bukas ng umaga ay meron tayong ino-offer na recollection, no, prayer, no, sa UST, no po, mula alas 8:30 hanggang tanghali. Lahat po tayo na may mga gagampanang papel doon sa visit ng Pope, magsama-sama muna ho tayo kalahating araw ng pananalangin, pagninilay, pangungumpisal, no? Pagpapakabanal, para pag-cover natin noong event, hindi lang tayo outsider na nagre-report, kundi nakakapasok tayo doon sa diwa ng nangyayari. So makita-kita rin ho tayo bukas. Oh. Sabi nga po kanina, magdala ho kayo ng mga panyo, tuwalya, para kung maluluha kayo ay may pampahid ng luha. Hindi na, it will be fun and it will be deep, no, yung ating preparation. Thank you.
Dadagdag ko lang. Alam niyo, sabi nga ni Cardinal Tagle na bukas nga po ay malaking event po ito para sa lahat po ng involved na committees for the papal visit. And he was actually telling me, no, that to really invite you, our secular media and even those in religious media, to please come to that event. Actually ho, yung bawat committee, binigyan lang ho ng allotment ko ilan ang pwede kasi hindi naman ho malaki yung venue. Nakiusap po ako for our committee to if they could accept more, no? So we have allotted around 100, no, for our secular media. So I hope yung invitation ni Cardinal Tagle, siya po ang magbibigay. Sabi lang po, kung po pwede, walang camera, no, at walang kung ano-ano, baka tayo po yung pumunta doon para we will be receiving, no, and preparing spiritually for the papal visit, no. Siya po ang magbibigay ng recollection at misa.
Kami hong dalawa.
Thank you. Allow me to reiterate once more. No, UST po sa alumni building behind the grandstand. It's tomorrow, December 3, Wednesday, 8 to 12 in the morning. We will have a holy hour conference, a talk, spiritual conference by His Eminence Cardinal Tagle. We will have a mass also and confession. So we would like to invite you. If you want to have a reserved seat, no, meron pa lang 80 slots. Please see us after the briefing so that we can reserve you. So it's tomorrow, 8 to 12, UST, Alumni Building. It's part of our preparation for the coming of the Holy Father, to be prepared spiritually also, in spirit, mind, and body. Are you coming? Who is coming? Let us see some hands. Yeah, no? Kaya lang, wala pong interview bukas. No? Wala kumukuha ng mga data. It's really for yourself. No? Spiritual renewal natin. Okay. Any other questions before? Yes. Last two.
Baka lang you have a, I don't know who to ask, but you, would you have an estimate of the number of priests in the country? How many are it? Because the different references give varying numbers. So mga, what would be a safe number?
Ako ho, hindi ko ho alam yung exact number. Pero during the last national retreat for priests, which was around 4 years ago, no ho, 2011, asobali three years ago, sabi po at that time, we were almost around, a little more than 7,000 priests all over the country, no po, religious and diocesan. So kaya that explains why every diocese or church local church was asked to send representation lang. Hindi sa mga pari lang kung lahat 'yon pupunta, hindi na rin kasya sa Manila Cathedral. Oho. Imbitado ho sila. May mga nagsabi ho na pupunta na sila kahit yung retired.
Okay, thank you very much. Salamat po tayo sa ating mga panelists, Cardinal Tagle, Bishop Mylo, Monsignor Cerbo, and Usec Jess Yu. And before we end, final blessing of the Cardinal, we would like to announce once more tomorrow, December 3, 8 to 12, spiritual preparation for the media at the Alumni Building behind Grandstand UST. And next week, exciting topic, December 12, 1 p.m. in this place again. Salamat tayo sa KFC, the Knights of Columbus building. Our topic would be the encounter of the Holy Father with the families. No? Families. At the MOA, Mall of Asia Arena. Dito natin pag-uusapan ano yung magaganap sa encounter of Pope Francis with families.